say so. We will get to what happened in Pennsylvania's 18th congressional district last night, because that actually, I have a lot of notes on that. But we begin today with this massive walkout that's happening at supposedly 2,500 schools all over America, where a bunch of kids, astroturfed by people who organized the Women's March, have decided to walk out of school for 17 minutes to honor the victims at the Parkland school shooting, the victims at Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School in Parkland, Florida. And of course, what this really is not a call for an agenda, right? It's not actually an agenda-driven march, right? We actually don't know what they want. And if you read what the Women's March say they are marching for, nobody agrees with their actual agenda. I'll get to their actual agenda in a second. But what it really is about having a lot of pictures of a lot of young people standing around and saying that they hate gun violence so that a bunch of leftist politicians can claim that they are standing with the children in pushing for vast gun confiscation regimes. That's what this is all about. And that's essentially what the New York Times admits in their editorial today. They say the children should lead us, which I say, fine, then let the children take over your editorial board. They can't do a worse job than you have. Why don't you just let the kids run all your op-eds? And they can decide whether they want to run op-eds on whether homework is necessary or not. It's really funny. All the adults at the New York Times, who are all in their 50s, they always talk about how wonderful and genius these 17-year-olds are, but I don't see them giving up their jobs anytime soon to high school juniors who are attending Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. But here's what they write in their editorial. They say, adults are supposed to take care of children, not only keep them safe, but make them feel safe. Weird. I don't hear this from the New York Times on issues like abortion, that adults are supposed to take care of children. I don't hear about them with regard to single motherhood. That line seems to go out the window. But now, of course, adults are supposed to take care of children, according to the New York Times, not by defending kids with guns, but by letting kids decide policy, which is a weird way of protecting them. They say schools are essentially an extension of the home in that sense, providing sanctuaries of learning, of nurturing and care. But after years of attacks by people with weapons of war, students cannot feel safe and are demanding that adults end years of complacence and act. OK, first of all, it is the school shootings are actually on the decline, not on the uptick, statistically speaking. And your chances of being killed in a school shooting are significantly worse than your chances of being killed in virtually any other sort of accident in the United States. And these are acts of terror, really. Say they're not asking for their schools to become armed garrisons. Well, some would like for there to be more armed guards. Say rather they want those weapons to be brought under control. I like how the New York Times has a direct link into the minds of all young people. It's amazing. It's like Rousseau's general will. They just look at young people and they magically know that all of Chuck Schumer's proposals on gun control have embedded themselves in the minds of young folks. But what is this smack of? It smacks of the New York Times basically taking a child, putting the child out front and saying, this child demands that you do what I say you do. Are you going to say no to this very cute child? It's like the Pinky and the Brain episode where they decide to take over the world by becoming small children with big puppy eyes. Right? The way to actually become leaders is to show something really cute. Well, that's what the New York Times is basically doing here. They say, at Stoneman Douglas Jr., Florence Yared said at the Florida State Capitol late last month, you adults have failed us by not creating a safer place for your children to go to school. So we, the next generation, will not fail our own kids. We will make this change happen. If not today, then tomorrow. If not tomorrow, next year. Take it from us. You created a mess with us, but we will make this world safer for our children. Again, you know, I understand that this girl went through something absolutely horrible, but the world is significantly safer for kids growing up today than it has been at any time, literally in human history. And if she thinks that she's going to be able to ram through gun control because something bad happened to her, I have another thing coming for her. She says, with Wednesday's demonstration and their March for Our Lives movement on March 24th in Washington, young voices are being heard. How will the nation's adult respond? Hopefully by amplifying their demand. Never again. So first of all, I love the use of the Holocaust terminology, never again, to describe what are rare instances of horrific terrorism. Not quite the same thing, but as opposed to, you know, like an organized government effort to slaughter 6 million Jews, not quite the same thing as people who being allowed to own guns because it is their right to do so. And then a couple of bad people going and doing really horrific things with those guns. Not quite the same thing as the Holocaust, but all right. And then they quote a bunch of high school juniors, right? And we're supposed to believe that all of these high schoolers are the wisest and greatest among us. Now, again, tragedy does not confer expertise. I've said this about Jimmy Kimmel and his son. Just because something bad happened to you in your life does not make you an expert on the underlying issue. Jimmy Kimmel had a surgeon perform the surgery on his son. He didn't perform the surgery himself because he understands that just because he was suffering doesn't mean that expertise goes out the window. The same holds true of gun control. Just because you witnessed something awful happen at your school does not mean you know what you are talking about when it comes to the best public policy to stop such shootings. But the New York Times, again, they want to use these kids as political human shields. And so here is what they turn over their editorial page to these kids. And then they quote them, right? Alfonso Calderon, Jr. No kid should be afraid to go to school. No kid should be afraid to walk outside. And no kid should have to worry about being shot. Now, that's why I'm marching. Okay, no kid should have to worry about leukemia. No kid should have to worry about disease. No kid should have to worry about murder. No kid should have to worry about anything terrible. That's true. I mean, that'd be great. Unfortunately, we live in a world where there are evil people. The question is, how do you stop them? We all want to stop those evil people. Okay, how about Ali Sheehy? Not Ali Sheedy, right? Ali Sheehy. The children, senior in high school, the children you pissed off will not forget this in the voting booth. Don't doubt the power of the younger generation because we are a force to be reckoned with. Okay, every young generation says this. Sometimes they are, sometimes they're not. But again, the idea that everybody who's young is solidly behind a particular gun proposal is just not true by polling. Emma Gonzalez, who's one of the people who's been featured the most in the media, and subsequently the media have been just enamored of her Twitter followers because she has gotten this big Twitter bump. She went from like nothing to 1.1 million because she was featured on Ellen and a bunch of other shows. So they quote her, maybe the adults have gotten used to saying it is what it is. But if us students have learned anything, if we students have learned anything, Emma, right? If you maybe you should learn some grammar. But if us students have learned anything, it's that if you don't study, you will fail. You should study grammar or you'll fail. And in this case, if you actively do nothing, people continually end up dead. So it's time to start doing something. We are going to be the kids you read about in textbooks. Not because we're going to be another statistic about mass shooting in America, but because we are going to be the last mass shooting. I fervently wish that this were true. I fervently hope that this is true. But just because we all want to stop mass shootings doesn't mean I agree with Emma Gonzalez's prescription. I mean, all of this is basically Bernie Sanders-style politics. I've ripped on Bernie Sanders' Twitter account for a long time because Bernie Sanders' Twitter account is largely Bernie Sanders just saying things like, there are rich people and there are poor people. The world should not be like this. I say, well, okay, fine. What you can do about it? Right? And this is the same thing. It's, there shouldn't be shootings of children. Yes, we all agree. Now, your proposal, please. And Jacqueline Corin, Jr. High schools shouldn't be hashtags every other day. Jose Iglesias, Sr. More prayer, Jesus, God, and compassion won't bring back the victims that sadly lost their lives. I'm not sure anyone was making the contention that more God was going to bring back children who died. It won't bring back the sense of security that my fellow peers and I lost. The only way to get that back is through gun control starting now. Weird, because there is significant gun control all over Chicago and people don't feel particularly secure. Okay, gun control doesn't make people feel secure. Lack of being shot makes people feel secure. The only reason that you would embrace gun control over, for example, more armed security guards is for political reasons. So make an argument. I love this. Madison Leal. The children will become leaders as the leaders have become children. I don't even know what that means. It's always selective. So the New York Times did turn over one of the editorials on their editorial page to a sophomore at Randolph High School, a junior at Toms River North High School, and a senior at Marlboro High School, all in New Jersey. Again, this is just political human shield stuff, right? They're going to bring out a bunch of young kids and then suggest these kids know something better because they are kids, which is weird. And they write, we are Generation Z, this is in the New York Times, the generation after millennials. We outnumber them by nearly 1 million and maybe the largest cohort of future American spenders since the baby boomers. We have more than $30 billion in spending power and wield enormous influence in family spending. Our spending power will only increase as we begin to earn our own wages. We will flex our muscles at the ballot box, too. Many high school seniors will cast their first ballots this November. And in 2020, a majority of today's high school students will most likely be able to vote in their first presidential election. Let us remind politicians like Donald Trump, Paul Ryan, and Mitch McConnell, who accept donations from the NRA and oppose efforts to restrict gun purchases, that we are the future leaders and voters of this country. Well, I'm sure that some of you are and some of you are not. I mean, there are lots of people who vote. There are lots of people who don't vote. There are lots of people who lead. There are lots of people who don't. There are lots of people who are young who will join the NRA. There are lots of people who won't. Let us remind corporations like FedEx that provide discounts to NRA members that we are their future customers. Again, this is not an argument. This is a moral appeal, right? It's an emotional appeal. Now, the reason that I'm reading all of this from the New York Times is to demonstrate that they're rather selective in the folks that they choose to feature, because there are a lot of young listeners to the Ben Shapiro Show. There are a lot of young people who listen to the show. Something like 70 to 75% of our audience is under the age of 35. We have a disproportionately young audience, of which we're very proud. And we have tons and tons of high schoolers who listen to this show. And I've been getting overwhelmingly one message from my emailers over the last 2 weeks. And I mean this. I'm talking about scores of emails. I'm talking about probably more than 100 emails from high schoolers over the last week alone. And today, many, many more after I wrote this piece, who are saying that they are upset with the media coverage of this mass walkout and asking for advice on how to deal with it. I've gotten lots and lots of emails from these folks. So here are some of the emails. And I want to read the emails from some of these students who are not going to be featured in the New York Times. I want to read some of the emails from these students who are not going to be shown on network news tonight. I'm going to read the emails from some of the students who are going to be ignored and castigated and told that they are worse, that they are worse human beings because they disagree with gun control. I want to give them a voice because the media, the rest of the media, certainly are not giving these kids a voice. And I am speaking with these kids, I promise you, far more often than the editorial board of the New York Times is. The editorial of the New York Times hasn't talked to a person under the age of 40, except for like this last couple days in years. I'm talking to people under the age of 20 every single day. Okay, so I'm going to read some of the things that they've been sending to me and let them speak. Okay, so I'm going to turn over my show to them in just 1 second. But first,